Not bad.
How do you like that?
And this week we're getting some more snow, but really it's the rain we're talking about right now.
Big time rain along the coast. And also up at Meadows, which we're going to show you here in just a second, saw the groomer operating up on the hill. Wonder what that could mean. All right. Mount Meadows, it is 34 degrees, Seaside 55, and it has been raining nonstop, just like this, major downpours for at least the last hour and a half. As we take a look at downtown Portland, we've seen some light rain come through, but nothing compared to the coastline. 51 degrees, wind is out of the east at about 10 miles per hour. Seen some gustier conditions along the coast ahead of this front, and it's mostly the coastline that will be impacted by the biggest rains. That's why a flood watch is in effect, and that remains in effect through tomorrow afternoon. Notice in areas of yellow and orange, that's where rainfall rates upwards of an inch to an inch and a half an hour are falling. As we zoom out a little bit further here, we can see snow in our mountain areas. Snowfall will be down to about 4,000 feet, so a winter weather advisory goes into effect starting early tomorrow morning, lasting through a good portion of the day. So snow at around 4,000 feet, but even at 3,500 feet, what you'll get is some of that wintry mix, some kind of that slushy stuff that can certainly cause problems for you on the roadways. Let's zoom in a little bit closer to the coastline and take a look at what's happening here. We've had thunderstorms offshore make their way onshore, survive onshore. But thanks to the fact that we have a nice big coastal range, that's going to stop the development of most thunderstorms from moving further to our inland valleys. But still, heavy downpours can be found in Willamette Valley and also over to the eastern side of the metro. There's your winter weather advisory. Again, in effect through tomorrow night, that flood watch will be with us through tomorrow afternoon, and then it looks as though the rain is going to back off considerably. Snow down to 4,000 feet. We don't expect it to get much lower than that. That's the good news. If you're along the coast, though, watch out for isolated thunderstorms and much of a lightning show for you through the early morning hours. In the valley, gusts could reach 30 to 40 miles per hour. Here is the satellite radar imagery showing you our big area of low pressure. Now, ahead of this front, this is where we're seeing all the activity. But as soon as that front transitions over to the east and moves a little bit to the southeast, that's when we can expect much colder air to be associated with this. This will be more of an impact, again, bringing those snow levels down a little bit further. In addition to that, it adds to the instability that already exists in our atmosphere. So thunderstorms on and off throughout the day. But again, most of that being concentrated right here along the coast. How much snow could we get here by the time we get through tomorrow? Anywhere from 6 to 12 inches, of course, the largest amounts being above 4,000 feet. Rainfall totals, what could we see? Well, as we move ahead to tomorrow night, by the time we get there, we're expecting rainfall totals to range anywhere from about 1.5 to 2 inches in some locations, inland valleys anywhere from about 3/4 of an inch up to over an inch. Mountains, again, it'll be in the way of snow, anywhere from 6 inches to a foot of snow in a 24-hour period. Looking at tomorrow's high, 50 degrees, but be aware the next few mornings, waking up to temperatures only reaching the low 40s. Daytime highs, a little bit below average, 47, 49. We get into Saturday and Sunday, almost a repeat of last weekend, where a very weak ridge of high pressure kind of comes in and buffers things out, gives us a little bit of a break from the rain. But then we're right back to it as soon as we get to Sunday night.
And that's chilly. I put an extra blanket on the bed even at night.
Oh, absolutely. Without a doubt.
Yeah, plus you got Buddy the dog.
Yeah, oh yeah, he jumps right up into bed.
That's perfect.
Thanks, Natasha.
Still ahead.